You still have Virgin Atlantic, but it broke my heart to read that you sold Virgin America to Alaska.
I didn't sell Virgin.
Okay, Virgin America was sold to Alaska Airlines.
It broke my heart too. So I think you have this rather strange situation in America that that British people. We can own banks in America, we can own spaceship companies in America, we can own hospitals in America, we can own lots of things, but we're not allowed to own an airline. And this has been a really clever move by the big airlines to try to protect their patch, and they've managed to lobby and fight and keep a situation where only only people who with American passports can own American Airlines. And so when we set up Virgin America, we had to bring in venture capital organizations to own it. And we were a minority shareholder. And sadly, they had an offer they couldn't refuse, and they sold it.
So there goes the cabin with the purple lights. I have to, since you're here, let me ask you this. What's up with the purple light? I mean, am I supposed to feel like I'm walking into a club in South Beach or Ibiza? Or is there some other thing at work with the purple light? Because no one else does it.
The exciting thing about starting a company or starting an airline is you take out a big blank sheet of paper and you think, oh, this is what you should do, I think. And you're painting a painting. You're trying to get every single little thing right on that canvas. Number one priority is you get the friendliest, best people to work within this canvas, work within your airline. But then every little detail must be right. So when you walk on, you must feel into an airline. You must feel, wow, I feel at home. I feel welcome. The quality of the seats, everything must be right, and I think that's what the team at Virgin America achieved. And